it was all past film.
Yeah, these are all. Yeah, these are all past films that actually won. So these are all of our past winning films that, like, not award winning, but selected films.
Okay.
And you can see that, you know, this is 2004. We have a lot of VHS. Then over here for 2000.
I didn't realize that. Yeah.
And then over here in 2013.
Big beta tape up there.
Yeah, 2013 is all DVD and Blu-ray cases. So you can kind of see the history of distribution. Behind me as well. So
that'll look funny because in a couple of years we're going to be down to the USBs, flash drive thing.
Yeah, this year more than ever, I got more emails asking if I could, if they could just send me a link.
A link.
Yeah, like a Vimeo link or a Dropbox link or whatever, where I could just watch it online as opposed to even mailing me anything. So now for us, we still show the hard copy. So it's like, well, I could watch it, the Vimeo link, but you still have to send me the DVD to show.
Yeah, that seems plausible.
So I'm like,
if there's a store or something, right. I mean, yeah, if you can't get the link up, I would think, because I've seen a lot of things about, you know, you can put so many gigs on a flash drive these days that it can be this big now. Send your movie in on a little keychain you can wear around your neck.
Right.
I see that happening within a couple of
years. And we have gotten some flash drives with a digital version of it, as well as like their press kit and all that kind of stuff on there.
Oh, you've already done that? People have submitted that already?
Yeah, we've seen people submit stuff with a flash drive. Yeah. So
I can ask you, what is the value of a filmmaker sending something in? You have your date that the event opens, and then you have a closing date, and someone sends in a great DVD film that they made, and you all pass it around, you watch it, you're hooping and hollering about it. And then after, 3, 4, 5 months, I don't know how long the typical submission process is open. It seems like probably several months there because I know I've seen them without a box. It breaks down into 25, 35 to begin with. Towards the end, you're paying like $75 to get in because, you know, now it's like they're down the wire, pal. But is there some smarts to a filmmaker? Are there people out there that are aware of, or is this even happening, where they'll send it in right at the wire because they know that it's fresh and everybody's going to watch it at the last minute? Maybe it's worth paying that little extra for them to get that fresh in your minds, because the one you've seen that you thought was going to be maybe a winner, you've all watched about it and talked about it 3 years or several months ago, and the hoopla is all worn down by now, and this one's fresh at the end. Does that happen, you think?
Not really.
The selection process?
Yeah, not really, because, I mean, a great film stands out no matter what, and so if you're the great film that we all watched at the beginning, then you're still the great film that we watched. You know, I mean, we don't forget about good films, you know.
Yeah.
And it's not like, maybe if it was like there was a 4 year gap in between, you know, it's like, you know, okay, the first Star Wars movies were great, but this newer Inception was better, you know, because I've seen Inception more recent than Star Wars. Well, that would be the case if we had a huge time, but we usually, I mean, with only a few months, the good films still stand out at the end of the day. And a lot of times, filmmakers in general send stuff at the end as a whole, just because creative people are procrastinators.
I know.
So we don't usually get that many films at the beginning. Like, we open up our submissions usually in January, and we don't really start getting a whole lot of films until April. So for about 3 months, we might get, you know, 5 or 6 films, where then we get, like, all the rest of them after that. And obviously the big thing is, too, I mean, like you mentioned earlier, when you're asking the question, the deadline, you pay 3 times the amount.
I noticed that. You would get $75 at the end.
Which is, that's a without a box thing. Like, personally, I don't really care if you send it in at the last minute or if you send it at the very beginning, as far as how much you should pay. But without a box forces us to charge people more to encourage them.
Yeah, if someone's going to, which reminds me, someone's going to send a film to your particular festival, they have to go without a box.
Well, they don't have to.
Drop it in the mailbox?
Yeah, they can just drop it in the mailbox too. Oh. Most people do it through without a box just because that's easier and that's how they find out about it. But you could do it through without a box.
Do you guys, that reminds me, do you guys require an electronic press kit, EPK?
We like to have a press kit for the program.
Because I know without a box, you can, like, sit there and list that, and whatever movie you put out, I guess there's, like, a basic version of it that you already have it online. You don't have to, for the filmmaker, it's nice. You don't have to go through the trouble of doing it again. You stick it all online once, and then...
Yeah. So we don't need as much of a press kit as a lot of film festivals probably do. What we really want for is the program, so we need, like, the synopsis and the picture that's going to be in the program for your film, you know, and who the director was, that we can list the name, and, you know, that those kind of things, when it was made, all that.
I noticed most of them just eyeballing it here, and I'm a little nearsighted, but they all look like they're, like, professionally packaged, you know, with the label and everything, and some kind of pictures on stuff on there, so people don't usually just send them in the typical jewel case.
No, I mean, and there are some, I mean, as you can see, you know, there's a bunch there that are in jewel cases.
Oh, okay, missed that.
But it varies. But I mean, for the most part, people usually will put them in a case, and those a lot of times are too. They're like
is
exhibition.
Is it slant the judging a little bit when they look slick no. on the outside? I mean, you know, the cereal box is like
yeah.
When
no.
you open it up, it's not quite what well, box.
I mean, it obviously never hurts to have a professional, you know, packaging.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, it's all about the film. You know, I've seen some of the slickest packaging in the world, and then the movie stinks, you know? And then I've seen it where they send it to me in just a little plastic case that's broken because they put it in a bad envelope, and it's the best movie you've ever seen. You know, at the end of the day, we want to show good movies. Nobody else is going to see the packaging but me, so it doesn't really matter.
Is there a certain genre you've seen with submissions that you think might be a little untapped? I mean, you know, if zombies is popular one year... The Lone Ranger thing is, may have fizzled. It's hard to say right now. The jury's still out on that one. But what's I don't know what's coming next. Or you know, with you seeing so many, and you maybe are closer to seeing more. Your ear to the rail to see trends coming and going.
Yeah.
What do you we think is coming?
Well, I mean, as far as what's coming, I have to think about that for a second. I can tell you that stuff that is overtapped in my
opinion. Overtapped. Okay. There's one place to start.
Overtapped for sure, in my opinion, is the stereotypical independent films that's, you know, some kind of sort of, where somebody's trying to be artistic for the sake of artistic. And everybody wants to be the avant-garde filmmaker that makes this really great piece that, you know, and they don't want to ever really explain what's happening in the movie, so it's all up to your interpretation as the audience, and then they never really explain the ending, and it's like you end the movie and you're like, what did I just watch? Although that might make for a fun like screenwriting session or a fun filmmaking experience from like the film, like the people who select your films, like don't make that movie. Like it's confusing. The audience isn't probably going to like it. At the end of the day, like our goal is to fill our seats with people and make sure that they walk out enjoying the film. And if they don't understand what your film was about, then we're not going to show your film. You know, if I can't understand it and I like film and I do film and I study film and I, you know, like if I don't get it, then an average Joe that walks into our theater is not going to get it at all. So, personally, those are the films that I would encourage people to not make. Like, if you want to make the really art house independent film, I would just say wait until you make yourself famous, and then people will go watch it because you're famous. And, you know, if you're trying to make a name for yourself, like, make one with, like, a storyline that's followable,
mm-hmm.
where the good guy wins, or whatever, that, there, you know, there's some resolution to the story that you set up at the beginning. You know, that there's good conflict. I mean, like, just make a basic, solid, good movie like you've seen your whole life. You know, even though it might seem like, oh, that's what everybody makes. Well, everybody makes it because that's what everybody wants to watch.
That's what it works.
You know? And if you want to be a famous filmmaker, famous means that everybody knows who you are, and nobody's going to know who you are if nobody's watching your stuff. So that's the one that's, like, way on to... And every time I put one in, it's, like, immediately, like, I can tell what it is. I'm like, oh, great. Like, this is another one of those films.
Mm-hmm.
Now, on tapped markets, the ones that will always be in our film festival that, like, when I see it, I will put it in, is a good 5-minute short that's funny. Because we always have spots where we have 5 minutes left in the block.
Wow.
And if we can make our audience laugh, especially after some really depressing documentary about the world sucks and every, you know, and people are dying all over the place, or after this independent that's really great but it's sad because the mom died of cancer and the daughter had to find a way to move on. It might be a really touching story, but after that it's like, it's nice to cheer the audience up a little bit.
Oh.
And a 5-minute funny short will always play at our festival, even if it's like a mediocre funny. If you want to do something and you're not sure if you can do it that great, a 5-minute funny short. And like, has to be 5 minutes. Like anything longer than 5 minutes, then you're then in the range of like, eh, you might be too long to fit in that block. But we always have 5 minutes in almost every block.
It seems like a great idea. Do you keep some from the past in case you don't get any like that? To go, you have them right there. It's like, okay, you know.
Yeah.
We know we're going to have this movie.
We've shown some.
Something.
We've like one night, one the week, the year we had the zombie films
mm-hmm.
that I was talking about, the zombie night, we pulled out a film from a couple years back that was a short that was funny about these two little kids. One was dressed up as a princess. The little girl was dressed up as a princess.
She
was running around dressed up as a princess. Like, I mean, being like a little girl playing in the yard kind of thing. And then all of a sudden she found this zombie boy. And they're like the same age. And then he was all, you know, being a zombie, obviously. And so then she is scared at first. And then she like grabs his hands and starts like dancing around with him like little kids would play almost.
So this was the movie or the one you showed after?
This is the short. After it. So this
is
the funny.
Okay, so still zombie connected.
Yeah, so it's still zombie
like,
connected. Yeah. So it was just a funny little short of these, you know, this little girl playing with a little zombie boy, basically, and then it ended. And it was just funny because it was a zombie boy, you know, playing. I mean, so it's humorous. But normally we don't bring films out from the archive just because we want to be, we don't want to take up time to show a new filmmaker of a filmmaker that we've already shown before. You know, we're all about trying to give filmmakers a chance to show off their
freshies.
Work. Yeah, exactly. We don't want to take up time slots that should be going to the new guys that have submitted than playing stuff that's already been played before.